Hi, Alex here from Rebelloper.com, and in this video I am going to talk about GitHub and Xcode 9 and how easy it is to work with them together. So without further ado, let's get started and take a look at our resources. Of course, if you don't have any images, I urge you to go ahead and go to rebelloper.com/Pablo, and there you can sign up for a flat rate unlimited designs for your app. Before we get started, let's take a look at what we are going to do. First of all, we are going to create an Xcode project that we will backup to GitHub. So let's open up Xcode and let's create a new project. Click on File, New and Project. And of course, we will create a game because a game is always more exciting than a single view application. So click on Next. And I will call this select Swift for the language and click on Next. And now here comes the most important part. Let's select our folder where we will save it, and let's create a Git repository on your Mac, because of course you know when you create Git, you create essentially one repository on your Mac that is local. And if you want to push it up to the cloud, you can create a repository on GitHub or Bitbucket. In our case, we will create it with GitHub. So important, check source control and we will create Git repository on my Mac. Click on Create. And finally, we have created our first project with GitHub. And if we just take a look at our example project, you will see a Git hidden file here. If you do not see your hidden file, then go ahead and open up Terminal. This is not essential, but you can do that. Anyway, the hidden file will be there if you see it or if you don't. Go ahead and type in this line of code, defaults write com.apple.finder, Apple show all files and true. Okay, hit return. And after that, relaunch Finder with kill all. And there you have it. You will see all of your hidden files here and your local Git repository. And of course, if you want to remove seeing those hidden files, just select the false version and of course, relaunch Finder with the kill all Finder command. Okay, now that we have that done and we can see our local Git repository, let's go ahead and create something that worth saving into this Git repository. So go ahead and inside Xcode, let's find our gamescene.swift file. And first of all, let's delete everything from here because we will not need this in our example project. So all you should leave is our did move to view function. Let's delete all of this and maybe just move it slightly to the left. Okay, and one last thing, in our gamescene.sks file, just delete this label. Here we go. Let's just build and run, select iPhone 10. And let's see if we broke anything at all. No. It is building up, compiling, and build has succeeded. Okay, just to be on the quick side, let's drag and drop these two assets, player one and player two, into our assets Xcode assets catalog, and you will see a little zombie and a crazy clown. We will use these to add them into our scene. So as you can see already, we have some modified files. This M here means that these files were modified and not committed. Okay, to do commit them in our local Git repository, go to source control and click on commit. And as you can see, here are all of our changed and or modified files. And let's enter a commit message. Let's say cleaned up and added two images. So that's it. And we will commit these 8 files. And as you can see, the M's have gone away because no more modified files are available in our Excel project. Great, good stuff. Let's take a look at our simulator. And it has launched successfully. As you can see, here is our info label with the nodes and the frames per second. Okay, let's go ahead and stop that and add our zombie, the player one PNG, to our game scene. To do that, let's just create an SK sprite node. Let's call this player one, and it will be an SK sprite node with a file named, and that will be player one. Okay, now that we have created our SK sprite node, let's position it to the center of our scene. For that, let's type in player.position equals CG point. And let's select this one with the CG floats, and that is self.size.width, and we will select half of our width and self.size.height, and we will multiply it by 0.5 again for the height. That's it. We have our position. Now let's add our Z position. Player one and Z position equals, let's say 1.0, because it is a CG float. And now, oh, sorry about that. I can see here are some optionals. Let's delete that and not file named. It should be, it should be SK node, image named. And the optional would go away. Okay, and that is player one. Great, good stuff. And now, finally, let's add it to our seed. Let's add child player one. Okay, let's see what happens. Let's build and run. Okay, as you can see, here we have our sprite. Not well enough. For that, we need to add our anchor point to our scene, and that is self.anchor point equals CG point, and that is 0.5 and 0.5. Okay, and I will just scale this sprite down. Player one, set scale to, let's say, half of its original size. Let's build and run again and see what happens. Okay, I believe that we have put out, let's put it in the zero, CG point zero now. Let's build and run again. This is how coding works. We just try it and test it out, and there we have it. We have our player one sprite at the center of our scene. Good stuff. So we have once again modified our gamescene.swift file, so we need to commit it again. So let's commit it. Let's commit one file again. And as you can see, the modified, the M letter here again disappeared. Now, what is interesting about this is that we already have a source control right inside Xcode 9. And if you tap on this little icon, the second icon, the show the source control navigator, then you will see our GitHub example master. And this, if you just unpack this, and you will see our branches, our tags, of course there aren't any, and our remotes that I will talk about in just a minute. And if you just select our master, as you can see it is current, you have already here our commits. We have our initial commits, a commit, our cleaned up and added two images, and our finally added zombie sprite commit. And of course, you can filter it like a zombie. Of course, we have found our added zombie sprite commit here. Okay, let's clean that out. And now, if we want to, let's say, work on a new feature, and then we would likely create a new branch, and that is so that we do not mess up our master branch. So let's create a new branch here, and we will create it from the master so we may add new features to it, and that will be the crazy clown sprite. So let's create a branch from the master. Okay, and I will name the branch crazy clown. Okay, let's create it. It is not a valid branch name. Maybe we aren't allowed to add spaces. So let's create it like this. Okay, and here we have our crazy clown, and Xcode already took us into this branch. So we are in this current branch. Now let's go back and add our crazy clown sprite. And I would just copy and paste this player one sprite node code, and just simply change this real quickly to player two. And of course the image name should be player two again. And now I will just not position it to CG.0. I will just change this out. Okay. And it should be one by the other. So the width should be self.size.width, and let's multiply it by 0.33, and the height should be self.size.height multiplied by 0.5. And the same goes for our player 2 sprite. The difference is that we will add it to the right of our player one sprite. Let's build and run and test this out. Oh, we need to add the parentheses. Let's see how this looks. For some reason, they aren't at the point that I want them to be. Oh, yes, of course. We need to set in the game scene SKS to be of the size of, let's see here. Yep, we have a very large size here. So maybe we will just add both of them to the center again. CG point, let's say 100 by 100, and that will be fine by me. Okay, let's see how it all looks now. Okay, here we are. And maybe let's make this Y 0 and this 100. Okay, let's build and run and see the two players, player sprites one above the other. Good stuff here. So we have modified our branch. And let's commit this branch as usual. And let's say added crazy clown. Great. Let's commit one file. And let's take a look at our git. Okay, we have added crazy clown, and if we wanted, then we could take a look at the assistant editors. No, sorry about that. This one, let's change this and take a look at what happened in the code. Let me just take this out here. And here are the changes that were made inside our branch. So we have changed our player one position and added our player two. Okay, good stuff here. So one final thing I want you to take a look at is the differences between the master and the current. As you can see, the crazy clown isn't inside the master. So what we can do now is merge the crazy clown branch inside of master, because we really like our changes. So go ahead and select master and merge crazy clown into master. So we are merging crazy clown. No, we are merging master. Yes, merge crazy clown into master. So go ahead and let's merge that. And here we can see our differences and click on merge. Okay, and inside the master, now we have added the crazy clown. And that's it for local Git. In the next video, I will talk about GitHub and how you can save your project into the cloud and never lose it again. Okay, hope you liked this video. If you liked it, go ahead and click the thumbs up.